Hey everyone, today I'm going to be showing you my Thomas & Betts 100 watt high pressure sodium light fixture. And I picked this up at the ReStore for $15, and the lamp was cycling when the person said the lamp was cycling, and obviously that's the bulb. And I replaced the bulb with a 70 watt high pressure sodium bulb. It works fine, although this is only for demonstration purposes only, because it's the only bulb they had they were selling. So I actually had to go pick this up at a separate store rather than the ReStore, because I couldn't find any at the ReStore. This is the only bulbs that they had of high pressure sodium at the store. And it's a Brink 70 watt high pressure sodium bulb, although I shouldn't be doing this. This actually makes the bulb not last very long. But anyways, I'm going to set the camera down and show it warming up. So I actually did make a video of this thing starting up, but that video got deleted. Here we go. So you can see there, almost instantly this was actually warmed up. Now, so you can see there, it's not as it's actually now giving off an orange color because it's not fully warmed up. And gonna cover up something with the foot or something. And it's not fully warmed up, but anyways, you get the idea.
As you can see there.
And it's quite nice, not fully warmed up once again. Now the that bulb up there looks more of a daylight bulb, but it's not, so. Anyways, waiting for this to warm up here, and you'll see the mercury mix in with the sodium arc, and mix it in with the arc stream, you know, and then it'll just be sodium. So, and then it will just be that yellowish color, that, you know, that familiar yellowish color, whatever you want to call it. So, anyways, it's Thomas & Betts 100 watt high pressure sodium fixture. So there it goes, now the mercury mixed in with the sodium arc. It's actually a 100 watt Thomas & Betts EVA head, high pressure sodium. And yeah, now it's giving off more of a yellowish color. It's actually probably not as orange as it looks on camera, but it's actually like a yellow, very yellow color. Now I'm gonna go shut the lights off so you can see it. There we go. So yeah, it's quite nice. See there. And now I'm gonna go turn these lights on. And shut the fixture off so you can see it shutting off. So you can see there. It's actually not plugged in or anything. It's actually glowing because the sodium is still vaporized and it's hot, so. Anyways, it's quite nice, and it smells like a tungsten filament or something. It's actually, this fixture doesn't get as hot. It's actually, the ballast in this fixture is a lot more cooler than the, it actually operates at a much lower temperature than the fixture in my 175-watt American Electric home. Anyway, but, you know, what I'm trying to say is that this ballast in here operates at a lower temperature, meaning it doesn't get as hot as my 175-watt American Electric mercury vapor light fixture. And the ballast in that thing gets so hot that you can't touch it. And you can actually, if you hold your hand to it, you can feel heat from it, but anyways, thank you for watching. Please like, comment, rate, subscribe, and I'll see you later.